folks.
See what I got going on. So what I'm doing is I've started to modify this carpenter's axe, half hatchet, carpenter's hatchet, whatever you want to call it. I want to turn that into this. And what I'm doing right now is using a cut wheel on my angle grinder. Yeah, it's very slow going. You cannot overheat the steel, especially if you don't have a way to re-temper it. Basically, just a couple swipes, as you can see on the video, and then I'm sponging it. I'm about ready to have to run and get some more water, and I'm going to continue on this. And as soon as I get these lines cut in, I'll get back to y'all and show you what the next step is. Alright, so I used that cut disc and I got most of the meat out from down in here. And now I'm going to go to using a flap disc with the grinder. I don't like using a brand new one. Try and use ones that I've worn down. That way, this is where it gets really important that you don't overheat your steel. So I'm gonna get one of these old flap discs up on the grinder and keep getting at it. And this is where I try and make it the actual, really shape it out the way I want it, but it's coming along. Alright. It's not yet complete, but just wanted to bring it in and show you all what I got going on. As you can see, just got to take it easy, take your time. As in the video, I keep touching to feel to make sure it's cool enough and I'm not going to overheat the steel. I'm going to keep working at this. We're getting there. And I'll get back with y'all in a few minutes. Hang tight. Alright, so we almost got her. I'm just doing the final little touches, getting a few nicks out of it. This side's almost done, as you can see. And this side I still got to do some working on. I don't want to take out any of the stamp, the Falls City. I'm right on the edge of it, so I got to be careful there. Basically, we've almost got her to where we want her. And it's going to be a nice bearded axe. And then I have a handle that I carved from a piece of ash that I will hang this head on after I'm done. I'm going to get back to it. What I've been doing, it was thick steel up through here, basically using that flap disc. You want to just hit it on angles. You don't want to go straight into this. It's too thick and it just wouldn't work out that way. So what I do is thin it out on one side, get it kind of shaped up more of like a convex edge, switch it over, do the same things you can see right here, and then I take it out down here when I make the steel thinner down in there. So I'm going to get back to it, try and get this finished up in the next couple minutes, let you all see what I got going on and see the end product, close to the end product. It's all about patience. Not overheating the steel. Don't ever get a shop series angle grinder. These things suck. I gotta use channel locks to get it. Turn it on. Thank you. at it, try and make sure it's getting to be the same on both sides. Try and make it as even as I can. I still got a little bit down here I got to take out. But besides that, say it's getting to be where it's about good. Turn this from a 2 pound hatchet head into probably a pound and a half, but it'll be a good little trail hawk pack axe to take out in the woods with them. Once I get a handle on it. All right, here it is, folks. I guess over it all, it took me about an hour and a half to get to this point. I still have to do something with profile and edge, do a couple things, but that's basically the gist of it. How you get it shaped, modified into bearded hatchet. Started off like this. We took out where the nail puller is, pretty simple, and we shaped it into this. Maybe I'll do a video on when I actually hang the head and get her all fixed up. I have a handle I've been working on, made from ash I found along the river. Pretty good piece, and we're probably going to set that up with this. Maybe around an 18 inch handle, turn it into a nice little pack axe. Something to take out in the woods with you. Give this thing some new life. So that's it, folks. Hope you all enjoyed it. Maybe learned something. It's all about just taking your time, patience. You don't want to overheat the steel. If it starts getting discolored, it is way too hot. If you can't put your hand on it the whole time and hold your hand there, skin to steel, and it's too hot, then you have it way too hot. Just make sure you have some water and a sponge, and just every couple swipes, keep cooling it off until you get to using the flap disc. And at that point, if you use a worn out flap disc, it's kind of hard to really overheat it unless you're really just laying on it. So hope you all enjoyed it. Maybe like, share, and subscribe. You'll have a great day. Happy Valentine's Day.